Good morning. So today has started off very well because today's kind of marked the start of a new chapter of Lydia and my life. We started to look for houses. I find that very exciting. I cannot wait to move. It's going to be a huge move this year for us. And yeah, that started today. So we've been getting very excited this morning, like looking at property online and seeing the kind of things we like. So yeah, today started off well, but now we've both just finished off getting ready because we have a day of events and meetings down in London. But before I go, I just thought I'd quickly show you what I'm wearing. I've gone quite khaki today, actually. I've got a green Topman t-shirt on with this diesel khaki overcoat. It's quite hard to see in this light, but this is kind of khaki colored. It's not beige. And then I've got some distressed denims and some Chelsea boots in suede. So yeah, that's my OOTD for today. And our taxi's outside, so we're gonna get going.
See you later, baby. Bigger girl.
So just arrived down here in London, and when we was at the station a second ago, I was with Lydia and we grabbed a couple of coffees, and I think I've literally like deleted a layer of skin off the top of my mouth. It burnt me so bad, it's proper schoolboy error. I'm just about to arrive at this morning's event and then followed by a few meetings this afternoon.
I remember when I lost my mind. There was something so pleasant about that face. Even my emotions had an echo in so much space. And when you're out there with our care, yeah, I was out of touch. But it wasn't because I didn't know enough. I just want to Does that make me crazy? Does that make me crazy?
It's
finished off at the VO5 brunch, and it was really nice. The food was good. We had a live app, very talented young man. One thing that I wish I could do is sing. It annoys me that I can't sing. I'm kind of like a frustrated singer. We just finished off there now, and I'm going to head into Liverpool Street, and I'm going to go and meet Lydia to do a few meetings with her, and then I think we're just going to sort of like do a little bit of shopping in Harrods and stuff. So yeah, that's the plan. Just met up with Lydia.
Oh, hey!
And we've just done one of our meetings for today. We're now going to head to the second meeting of our day.
Yeah.
And we're running a little bit late.
What a little shock. Bit.
How late?
We're supposed to be there now, and we're in Knightsbridge, and it's in Oxford. It's on Regent Street. Oops.
Don't worry about that, standard.
Just got back from London. It was a pretty successful day. Had a really nice afternoon with the VO5 team, followed by a couple of successful meetings. I love going to the Laudrey for coffees, obviously macaroons ordinarily. My mouth is still so burnt from that coffee earlier. It's done me in completely. I'm gonna head to the gym now, get a workout in. Lydia stayed in London because she had another meeting on top of the ones that we did together, and I wanted to get back, make sure Lumi was okay, try and get my gym session in. Yeah, that's pretty much sums up the rest of my day, and then tomorrow I'll be seeing you again. So we'll see you like in the morning. Good afternoon. This morning I have been working, getting loads of stuff done. Now I'm just about to head out to go and get my hair cut from Greg. Greg's my hairdresser that you may have seen in some previous videos that I've done with him. He's had a new business venture. He's got a new shop, which I'm not sure if it's actually finished yet. I know they've been working very hard on it, him and his brothers, over the last couple of weeks. So I'm gonna go there to get my hair cut for the first time. Knowing Greg, he'll probably have a paintbrush in one hand and his clippers in another. But yes, we're gonna go there, get my hair cut, and then I'm thinking that we're gonna go straight to the gym. I'm in my gym attire. Yeah, I'm just sort of gonna run through a workout and how I train and how I like to go about my training. That is the plan of today. Lydia's just outside of Lumi, and I think she's gonna do a video of her own actually. So I've got about half an hour to get over to Greg, so I'm gonna get my bits together and leave now. Lids, do you think it's too cold to have my roof down?
What's the temperature?
15.5.
Ooh, I think it's a 16 degree minimum.
You do. So I shouldn't put my roof down?
It's up to you, babe, it's quite warm.
Lydia and I have a rule that if it's above 16 degrees Celsius, I can have the roof down on my car. It's 15.5. But hey, I'm gonna be selling this car soon, so I think I better have the roof down, make the most of it whilst I can. See you in a bit, babe. Love you. See you later, Lumi. We've arrived at Greg's new barber's, and it was so nice to drive with the roof down. Let's go.
What's up, brother?
You good?
This is the crib, yeah? So this is the work in progress. Yeah, boy.
Good night, isn't it?
Yeah, we've been getting haircuts in Greg's house now for the last month, I'd say.
Yeah, about a month. Yeah.
Today we're getting a haircut in the new gaff. It's coming on nicely.
Not quite finished yet, but we are getting.
It looks sick, bro.
It's getting there, isn't it?
Yeah.
I think we've got flooring's going down on Saturday.
Yeah. At the minute, I'm having my haircut every week because we're trying to change the style of my hair a little bit. And you know, you go through that awkward stage. Well, that's kind of what I'm going through at the minute. So we're just like keeping on top of it every week. What I ask for is a zero, is it a half actually?
I'll do a half fade.
Yeah, so I do a half fade and then keep it long on top. And he kind of just chopped into it. Because we're growing it out at the minute, he doesn't really take much length off.
I'd do stress if we take the half fade maybe halfway up the head.
Yeah.
Instead of high, just so we can get a nice.
And we keep the weight up here.
Yeah.
So yeah, that's it. So we're gonna get to business, get this mop sorted out.
even got a tissue for me to wipe my neck. What sort of barber is this? I won't put that in.
So I just finished off having my hair trimmed up at Greg's new barbers, Unit 35, here in Milton Keynes, and there is nothing better than a fresh trim. It just makes you feel good, especially when the weather's like this. Like, it's nice. It's really nice. But I'm gonna head to the gym now and get my daily workout in, and then I think I'm gonna head back home and then do some more work, which I know is a little bit boring, but I've got a lot to catch up on. So that is the plan. So we're gonna go to the gym and get a big session done. I think today's shoulders, so we're gonna do shoulders today.
So we've just arrived, David Lloyd, and first tip, when you go to the gym, always have fluid with you because you need to stay hydrated. Second tip, one thing I don't want to see is people walking into the gym, jumping on the weight section, pushing their PBs, because that is how injuries happen. So to kick things off, I'm gonna do some warm-up exercises and I'm gonna do a little bit of cardio. Look at the size of these geezers. You're out of focus.
Tell you when.
Oh, it's just a silhouette of muscle. And then there's no way, Matt, you're squatting that. I do not believe it.
400 kilos.
But he's got the music in, he's focused. He's not listening to anyone around him.
Not listening to any negative march. When I walk up and kick him in the nads.
The focus. The focus is real today. But anyway, I'm gonna go get on with my session. That you work out your rotary cuff, because if you don't, then you're really asking for problems with your shoulders. A lot of the experienced trainers that I've been around have always said to me, make sure that you warm up your rotary cuff before you train. Rotary cuff is basically like the core of your shoulder. So massive piece of advice is make sure that you always warm up properly, because whatever you're training or whatever you're doing within training, make sure that your muscles are prepared for what they've just had to go through. So yeah, I'm gonna go into a warm-up set now. So I've warmed up the body, but this is kind of like a feel set slash warm-up set. I'm just gonna grab some dumbbells, go straight into a compound movement. We're gonna be doing some military dumbbell shoulder press. Right, so just finished off doing that compound movement, really feel the blood now, going through the shoulders. So we're gonna drop it down, do some isolation work, do some side rear delt back raises, just try and hit the muscle in many different angles as possible, just to try and stimulate that growth as best we can. So we've just finished off doing three sets of 10 to 12 reps. Shoulders are starting to burn now, which is really good. I really like it when I'm sort of like about halfway through my session, I can really feel the muscle being worked. So that's exactly where we are at the minute. I'm now gonna jump onto a machine and do another military press, which is very similar to what I've done. But I'm gonna sit backwards on the chair. Just be careful when you perform this exercise, because you haven't got any back support and technically you are supposed to face the other way. I really like doing it this way because I really feel it focus on the sort of entirety of my delt, so like really on the sides, and it sort of takes away a little bit of that front delt pressure. So yeah, we're gonna flip around, we're gonna sit down, and again, I'm gonna be doing 8 to 12 reps. I'm gonna increase the weight this time, each time I do it, just to sort of like really push myself and try and get that 80% work rate up. I'll run into your arms if you call me. Call me, please, call me, please. finished off on the machine. I just did 4 sets in the end. I worked from 12 to 8 reps, and I increased the weight by 10 kilograms each time. I know in that clip that I just showed, I just went from 20, stuck another 20 on, but I actually started against it, stuck a 10 on, and then went to 20 after, to put 40 on each side. So that's how I was increasing it. And then when I got to my last set, I could only get 8 out, a real struggle. So that's where you want to sort of be working to, really pushing yourself. We're now going to sit on a, I don't actually know what this is called, it's kind of like I know there's a name for this, I can't remember what it's called, but basically, I'm just basically going to be working on my front delts. I'm going to be grabbing the palms, I'm just going to be shoving it up in front of me. Again, I'm going to be working on 3 sets, 10 reps, just keeping that consistently throughout my workout. And then after we've finished here, we're going to go down to the bottom. We're going to stretch out for 10 minutes. I'm going to stretch my shoulders out, get rid of all the lactic acid that's built up. And then I'm going to go home, get some fuel. And that is my hour's fitness of the day done, dusted, and carry on doing work and being productive elsewhere. See you later, Matty. Big Matty. What? I did hit Big Matty. Look how big he is. The old Big Matty. Give us a wave. So I've just got back from the gym and I'm just about to get some food. And here is Lydia in her natural habitat.
I'm sloughing.
Lydia's missed a meeting. Rescheduled a meeting.
Rescheduled a meeting.
Because she's
busy. Because it's
really
hard to film cutaways without you now.
No. Well, we're going to have longer days, more light, which means more time to film cutaways.
Should we do them again? You have to film the cutaways again?
I can do.
Oh, babe, have you seen I've got a sty? It really hurts. No, don't come in close. They'll see my wrinkles. I don't have any wrinkles. Smooth as a baby's bum.
Good evening. So yesterday when I left the vlog, I had been to the gym. I came home and I did a ton of work and I slept. And then this morning I've woken up, I've done a ton of work, I've hit the gym, I've come back and I got dressed up for an evening with Lydia and the Mont Blanc team. And I just thought I'd quickly run through my outfit before we went. So to start, we'll start from the bottom. I've got some Aquascutum brogues on, which are very, very comfortable. And I've got a new Rees three-piece suit. It's really hard to see in this light, but it's actually got a nice textured pattern on it, which I really like. And then I've got a DKNY shirt, a Lumi in the background, and a Longines watch. And this evening's fragrance is Yves Saint Laurent L'Homme, which I've recently acquired, and it's a very sophisticated masculine scent, so it's very fitting for this evening's attire. Lydia and I are going to grab a photo. Hopefully this is going to make the thumbnail, and we're going to get down to London and enjoy the evening with the Mont Blanc team. I hold on to this storm cause I need to swept away, swept away. I'm cornered in the cold where you left me. Left again, left again. Oh, there's a jungle in my head growing wilder. And it's killing me, killing me. I cannot let you go. 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 Thank you. just got back from the Mont Blanc event and I think we're going to sign off here. It was a great evening, had loads of fun, and Lumi's going to say bye and we'll be seeing you on the next one. Peace.